The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Early in the morning, he came again to the temple. All the people came to him, and he sat down and taught them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and placing her in their midst, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman has been caught in the act of adultery. Now in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such. What do you say about her?" This they said to test him, but they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. And as they continued to ask him, he took up and said to them, "Let him who is without sin among you be the first to throw a stone at her." And once more he bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. But when they heard it, they went away, one by one, beginning with the eldest, and Jesus was left alone with the woman standing before him. Jesus looked up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go and do not sin again." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, God is good, and all the time. There is a gospel song. In this gospel, we do find these words: "As higher as heavens are above the earth, so is great the love of God. As far as the east is from the west, so Jesus took our sins far from us." I can say that when Jesus takes our sins far from us, it is a sign that he loves us so much, not because of who we are, but for the sake of who we might become. In the gospel of today, we read that the scribes and the Pharisees, they brought a woman to Jesus. "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. And in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such woman. What do you say?" This is a question addressed to Jesus. What do you say about this case? In fact, if we can go back to history, starting with the society of Babylon. In some societies, in fact, adultery was and still is condemned and sometimes punished. In the society of Babylon, the Babylonian code of law of King Hammurabi, that was in the 18th century before Jesus Christ, adultery was punishable by death through drowning. When we come to Rome and to Greece, the Roman law also was asking adulterous spouses to be killed. Now, in the Jewish tradition, the one we have heard today, it was said that the adulterers and the adulterer both should be punished. If it is to be stoned, they should be all of them stoned. And this you can find in Leviticus chapter 22 from 13 to 24, where adultery was to be punished by stoning. And if you want to find where it is written that both of them should be punished, it means the man and the woman, you read Leviticus chapter 20 verse 10. And now it is in this context that the Pharisees and the scribes are bringing the woman to Jesus. What do you say about that? Now, for your information, my dear brothers and sisters, remember, and it was somehow written in the gospel, that these people, they came to Jesus to test him. It was a temptation. Actually, it was not because they wanted to kill the woman, but they wanted to find reasons to condemn Jesus. Why? Because first of all, it was written in the Jewish law, not only that the woman should be killed. That was the Roman law and the law in Greece. But in the Jewish tradition, it was said, it was written that both of them, the adulterers and the adulterer, should be killed. Now, when they are coming to Jesus, they are coming only with the woman. Where is now the man? So, contradiction. But they are willing to convince Jesus Christ that this is what Moses commanded us in the law, to stone such woman. What do you say about that? Okay, another reason, when you read the book of Exodus, it will say that Jesus, God dictated, according to the mind of the Jews, God dictated 10 commandments to Moses. And one of these 10 commandments was, you shall not kill. Now, if Jesus could say, okay, she has sinned, then stone her, kill her, he would have contradicted the law and the 10 commandments of God. And yet he was saying that he comes from God, so he was supposed to know all these laws. So they are trying to find ways to condemn Jesus from his own words. But Jesus being God, he read the mind of the Pharisees, he read the mind of the scribes. He did not want to go in the same way with the Pharisees. He did not want to let himself trapped by human beings. He decided to respond to the question another way. And the response of Jesus to that question, what do you say about this case, is calling these Pharisees, these scribes who think they know, they master the law, he is calling them to a new commandment. And that commandment is the commandment of forgiveness and the commandment of love. My dear brothers and sisters, the invitation for us today is to make our lives a reflection of God's mind. God's mind, a mind whose thinking is forgiveness. A mind whose feeling is love. A mind whose doing is the acts of mercy. This is the invitation for us today. The Lord be with you.